So when we solve this elemental connectivity matrix, so we are going to get ke is equal to integration of v into b transpose of matrix b into d and b over dv. So when we solve this one, so we are going to get the ke is equal to ae into k divided by le square into the matrix of order 2 into 2, that is 1 minus 1 minus 1 and 1. So where ae is the cross sectional area of a fin element, so that is the expression for the first one, then elemental conductivity. The next one will be the elemental convection matrix. So we are dealing with the convection matrix. So h is the connective heat transfer here, so connective heat transfer coefficient, and n is the, you can see that the shape functions related to it, and then over ds. So here it comes for the elemental surface 3. So where ds is nothing but, again we are naming it as in terms of p into dx. So p is the perimeter of the fin, where it is related to 2 into width plus thickness. So we are going to get the perimeter. So he, again we are going to solve this nt, that is the transpose of this matrix n. So n in terms of what here, n1 and n2 we are going to get, and then again n matrix here. So originally this n is equal to n1 n2. When we do the transpose of this one, we will get in this form. So that we wrote here nt transpose of this matrix nt in terms of n1 and n2, here in terms of column and here in terms of row over a pdx. So when we do the multiplication of this two, so n1 the multiplication of matrix, so over an element length, we're going to get here n1 square into n1 n2, and again here n1 n2 and n2 square over a dx. So I have taken a p over here. This is the coefficient convective heat transfer, that is h, convective heat transfer coefficient into the perimeter over this with respect to the dx. So when we are going to solve with respect to what n1 and 2, the values of the shape functions here, whatever we got here, n1 is equal to x2 minus x divided by le, and n2 is equal to x minus x1 divided by le. So that we are going to substitute over here. So and we are going to, when we rearrange, so then we will get the overall elemental convection matrix in terms of h is equal to h into p into le divided by 6 into the order of 2 matrix, that is 2 1 and 1 2, that is the seventh equation. So the next one will be the elemental specific heat matrix. So there is a specific heat we are representing in terms of c or elemental is equal to 0, since the fin steady state heat conduction, so we are not interested in steady state problem, so this will becomes a zero. Then elemental heat generation, here the elemental heat generation, what is the heat generation, what is the amount of heat generated from the base and how it is moving, so that we need to know with respect to a vector. So generation with respect to vector, that is QE, the heat generation into the shape function with respect to transpose, that is the transpose of the matrix n into dv, is equal to q, that is overall q into le, qe, that is elemental heat generation into the n1 and n2 matrix into ae into dx over a length. So you can see that here 0 to le. So the q is the component of heat flux. We are discussing the heat generation here, heat flux, in which direction it is moving. So when we operate this one again with respect to n1 and n2, and if we take ae into q, that is a heat flux outside, and then when we solve, when we do the integration, we'll get the expression of this whatever the heat, that is elemental heat generation vector, is equal to that is f q over element is equal to ae into q e into le divided by 2 into matrix 1 into 1, that is the equation number 8. And then the last one is the heat elemental element heat flux vector. So again we need to know about in what another elemental area, in what efficient way it is moving, heat flux. So that we need to know, that is ds2. So again ds2 is nothing but p into dx, as we have taken from the previous the concept, that is q we have taken outside. So here we have mentioned s2 and ds2 and ds2 here. So it means that the overall length we need to put in terms of length, that is p into dx we are making here. So and then this S2 will turn to 0 to L with respect to dx. So P is the perimeter and dx is the small elemental strip, what you can say. And N, the transpose, you can see the transpose of matrix N is equal to N1 and N2. So when we do operate and when we solve this one, so we are going to get by how? If we put the value of N1 and N2 of the shape function, and we are going to get the final expression, that is the FQ of over the elemental is equal to P into Q LE divided by 2 and into the 1 into 1. So this is the ninth equation. And then coming to the elemental matrix, again elemental boundary convection vector. So this is the elemental boundary convection vector is, so again we are going to operate with respect to DS3, that is the area of the surface P into DX, right? Over T infinity. Why? Because the convection T infinity is thing, but here is coming from the free stream, the temperature we need to know about, right? So we're going to take the H, the convective heat transfer coefficient, into the free stream temperature. And if you operate with respect to the shape functions, right? So when we will get the expression as F, that is the elemental boundary convection vector is equal to H into T infinity LE into P divided by 2 into 1 into 1 matrix. This will get, and then next will be